Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of React, that is React version 19 on Windows operating system. And then I'll also show you how to create a React project and how to run that on our browser. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in the middle, you can always comment on comment sessions. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install React, you will need basically two things. One is Node.js and then Visual Studio Code. So for that, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and let's, just simply search Node.js download. So we'll download Node.js first. So click on Node.js, switch to this pre-built installer and then download the LTS version. Always remember to download the LTS version. So if you click on this drop down, you'll see that version 23 is also available, but it is not recommended. Alright, so always download the LTS version. So choose this LTS and click on this download button. Immediately we'll see that our Node.js is rightly started downloading. Next, software that we'll need is Visual Studio Code. So just open a new tab and just type over here Visual Studio Code download and hit enter. So that will show you this code.visualstudio.com. Go to their official site and here, depending upon what operating system you use, you need to download that product. For Windows, I'll just simply click on that. So thanks for downloading, and our Visual Studio Code is also just rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and you can see both these two products, Visual Studio Code and Node.js, are rightly downloaded over here. So let's install it one by one. Let's start with Node.js. Just double click on the installer. It will show you welcome to Node.js. So this is our Node.js installation wizard. Let's minimize our download directory and click on next over here. So these are our license agreement. Accept it. Click on next. So this is where our Node.js is going to be installed. Fine. Click on next. So all this is going to install. Click on next. Here it is telling whether you like to install Chocolaty. No, I don't want. I'll skip this and I'll click on next. So ready to be installed. Click on install and there you go. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes and you can see that our installation is rightly began. And you can see that our Node.js is rightly installed. So let's click on finish. So now that our Node.js is installed, it's time to install Visual Studio Code. Just simply double click on Visual Studio Code installer and these are all license agreement. Let's minimize our download directory and accept the license agreement and click on next. So this is where our Visual Studio Code is going to be installed. Totally fine. Click on next and it's going to create a Visual Studio Code folder, which is also fine. Click on next. Here you need to check all these different options and click on next. So ready to be installed. Click on install and you can see preparing to install and you can see installation is rightly started. So it will take couple of minutes, so by the time our Visual Studio Code get installed, I'll request you please do consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also I'm posting lot of videos. You can see recently I posted this video of how to install Angular, then Python, all that, even CodeIgniter project or WordPress tutorial, everything you will see on this channel. So do consider subscribing that channel and can also watch other videos as well. So let's wait for a couple of minutes over here. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our Visual Studio Code is rightly installed. Also launch Visual Studio Code is also selected. You can always click on finish, so that went to launch our Visual Studio Code and everything is fine. You can close this for the time being. So now that both our Visual Studio and Node.js is rightly installed, so now it's time to create our React project. So for that, let's on our desktop right click and create a new folder, naming it as React Projects. So all of our React projects should be inside this folder. So we name this folder like this, React Projects. Let's click on this address bar and type cmd to open our command prompt at this location, right? And now let's create a React project. So for that you need to just simply type in px space create dash react dash app, and then need to provide your project name. So let's give the project name as, let's say, hello world. So basically in px create react app space hello world, and just simply hit enter. So immediately you will see it is telling to create a React app. So okay to proceed, just simply type Y and hit enter. So immediately it's going to, you know, start fetching all the files from internet and going to install it. So you need to have active internet connection for this. So you can see creating our React app. So this might take a couple of minutes. So let's wait for some time. You can grab some tea or coffee and you can come back after, you know, 3 to 4 minutes. I'll be also doing the same. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that it is showing some error. So basically unable to resolve dependency tree. So it has also given one suggestion. So that is, it is telling to run this flag called legacy-peer-deps. So now let's do that. Let's type npm config set, just copy this flag, set legacy-peer-deps true. Alright, and just simply hit enter. So that's going to properly set our config. Hope for now our project should be creating properly. Now let's run that same command. So npx create dash react app, and then give name of our project hello world and hit enter. So hopefully now it will be creating our React app properly. So you can see that our hello world app is also indirectly created. So let's wait for a couple of minutes over here. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our project is rightly created. So success, our hello world project is rightly created. So here is our folder hello world. So let's go inside that project. So cd hello world and just simply hit enter. So we are inside our hello world project. So now let's invoke our Visual Studio code by opening this project hello world. So just simply type code space dot and hit enter. So that's going to launch our Visual Studio code by opening this hello world project over here. So here, just simply click on I trust the authors and let's maximize it. So this is our project hello world. So if we expand this src folder, we'll see all these files. So here we have index.js and here we have app.js. So if we expand this public folder, here we'll see this index.html, this logo and all these different things. All right. So now let's run this project on our browser. So for that you need to go to this triple dot of Explorer and you need to click on this npm scripts. So when you do that, it's going to show up over here, npm scripts. So this is what you need. So here you see we have all these different buttons now. All right, so you can, you know, click on all this play button to trigger your project to, let's say, start, build, test or eject or whichever you want. So that's one way you do, or else you can also go to terminal and, you know, click on this new terminal. So here also you can write your you know, some command to build your project or to run your project. So, you know, to run our project, just simply type npm start over here and hit enter. So that should be starting our project. But you can see that it is showing some error, like cannot find this module, that is basically this code gen AGV. So now some issue with our node module. Let's, you know, manually installed AGV. So just simply type npm install space dash dash save space dev AGV @7. All right, So you know, let's run this command. So npm install dash dash shape dash dev agb at the rate -7. So just simply hit enter. So that should be installing latest version of agb. So all these commands, like starting from this to the script that we have used to create our project, everything I'm going to put on our description, so we can get it from our description as well, so you don't need to worry. So you can see that our AGV is now rightly installed, everything is fine. Let's type that same npm start all over again, hit enter. So hopefully this should work now. So yeah, so you can see that now it is properly started, so starting the development server. And if you go to browser, you can see that on our localhost port 3000, it's rightly started loading our project and it has rightly launched. So our project, so our React project, is up and running locally on our system. All right, so yeah, so that's how you create a React project. So let's change something on our app.js. so what you are currently seeing over here is actually gets loaded from this section. So what you can do is you can remove all the stuff from header and let's create one h1 tag, and within our h1 tag let's type something like hello world. And if you just simply go to file and save this file, it could automatically just refresh it on our browser, and it's going to wipe out whichever things it was there before, and now it's going to show only this latest code that we have written, hello world, right? So that is actually coming from here, right? So in this way you can easily install latest version of React. So if you go to this package.json, you will see that we are using latest version of React version 19, and React DOM is also 19. All right, so yeah, so that's how you install latest version of React, and you can start working on your React project using this. So hopefully my videos are helping you. If my videos are helping you, please do consider subscribing our channel, and also don't forget to subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting lot of videos, so you'll be able to see lot of WordPress videos, PHP and all that. So don't forget to subscribe this channel. Today I'm going to show you the best way to create an e-commerce website in less than 50 minutes. So after watching this video, you'll be able to create your very own online store just like this for free. And your customer will be able to view your products and then will be add them onto your cart and then use your unique promo code to get a discount, and then they can even make orders right from your website. And also, if you're interested, you can also subscribe Geeky Script vlogging channel. So that's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.